What's going on?
Oh boy. I have Alzheimer's disease. Early onset.
Oh my God. I hate that this is happening to me.
But we have to keep the important things in our life going.
Merry Christmas.
We have to try, or we're going to go crazy.
This might be the last year that I'm myself.
Please don't say that.
You're so phenomenal in this. It's so amazing.
Thank you.
You know, it doesn't surprise me because you've had so many great roles over the years, so many great performances. But I'm wondering what kind of complexity there was here that you haven't had to face before, be it emotionally, mentally, because so much of it is internalized.
Right,
and
right.
There's nothing really showy about this.
Well, one of the things that was so compelling about the story and about the book, actually, too, is that it was a depiction of a disease from a completely subjective point of view. That never happens. Yeah. It's generally from the viewpoint of the caregiver or a family member, you know, just someone observing it. Mm-hmm. So to go kind of from the inside out, that was really really exciting. I mean, it's exciting as an actor, but also. Yeah, there's a huge responsibility because you need to get things exactly right.
What's it like? Like, what does it actually feel like?
Well, it's not always the same. You know, I have good days, bad days, and on my good days, I can, you know, almost pass for a normal person. But on my bad days, I feel like I can't find myself. I've always been so defined by my intellect, my language, my articulation, and now sometimes I can see the words hanging in front of me and I can't reach them and I don't know who I am and I don't know what I'm gonna lose next.
There were so many times you just see like the light switch go off and
right.
It's, you know, you're just not there, or even more heartbreaking is when you see Alice trying to be there. So was that a lot of, you know, kind of private rehearsal on your part, figuring out what the look was like, or did you kind of have to just live in the moment with it?
It was research. I was very, very dependent on research. And one of the things I said to Wash and Rich, to our directors, was that I didn't want to depict anything on screen that I hadn't actually witnessed. You know, so the research was considerable and really lengthy, and people were so generous with their time and their information, and so all of those behaviors that I would kind of file away and think like, okay, well, you know, and there would be moments like the moment where I'm reading my speech to Lydia, to Kristen's character, and I start to become angry, and then I shut it down. You know, that's one of the side effects, actually, of Alzheimer's disease, the kind of irrational anger.
Behavioral
stuff, and her inability to look her in the eye at that point, too. You know, so there are things that are behavioral, and there are things that are emotional, and I was just always really, I tried to be really, really clear in plotting out, like, what happened when and why.
Yeah, you had, Alice had such a great line that she's not suffering from this,
struggling yeah.
with it. What did that say to you about Alice and maybe what we all need to understand about Alzheimer's?
That was taken actually from a real speech that a woman named Sandy Oltz gave at an Alzheimer's conference. And Sandy was one of the women that I spoke to in doing my research, and she's such an extraordinary person. She was diagnosed at 45, and when I met her, she was 49, and she spent her 50th birthday on our set when I did that speech. And if you watch
what
the movie,
moment.
They cut to her in the middle of that speech. She has red hair, and she's lovely, really beautiful. And it was important that you know, Richard actually wrote that and put that in there.
Because seems like it's kind of an compelling. Emotional, though. You seem a little struck by that right now, remembering that day.
I mean, it was really, really compelling, and it was a wonderful thing that she said too, that not to see her as a sufferer. That she was struggling through it, and I think that's it too. The movie is about what is it like to live with something, mm-hmm. not about what is it like to kind of, you know, capitulate.
Right,
you know?
Right. Totally understand that.
Yeah.
Not, of course, to give anything away from the end for those who haven't read the book, but the end it kind of comes up so quickly, but then it's so lasting because it to me said in spite of everything, this still exists.
That remains.
That was so And it just, it has stuck with me in the day since I've seen that. It was that a, did you kind of wait toward the end to shoot that? How, you know, did,
no,
did that make
any... No, that was our ninth day.
Wow.
You know, you remember, when we shoot, we're just at the kind of behest of our locations. And so at that point, we were losing that house where we were shooting. So basically, we shot everything out in the house, then we moved on to other locations. So that was tough. I think that was tough for me, that was tough for Kristen, because it was the very, you know, it is the very, very end of the movie. We hadn't shot the preceding scene, which was kind of important. I didn't really know where I was going to be with the other stuff, you know, so you just kind of like throw yourself at it and see what'll stick.
Right. It's just, you're just so phenomenal in that. You're wondering what she's going to come up with.
Right.
And man, it's powerful,
thank
profound.
You.
It's hopeful
too. It is
too.
Profound. I think it is hopeful. And I think that that's why the movie is touching. And that's,
yes.
And that's because this is the stuff, this is what's important to all of us. At the end of the day, that's what it comes down to.
So live in the moment, I tell myself. It's really all I can do. Live in the moment.